Hi everyone, today's the day I am moving my veranda, which I dearly love. It's so pretty. And I did look and is a male, so yay, I gotta get him a female. But I'm gonna put him in the pond, and the only reason I'm gonna put him in the pond, I know they say not to put fancy tail fish, more than a single tail or whatever in the pond, but this fish is like a savage, like crazy fast. I'm not worried about him not eating because that's like the biggest thing. So he'll be fine. And then we are going to be putting Savage in there, which was my first goldfish that I started this with, in a freaking sad 6.5 gallon tank with four other goldfish. And he is very stunted, but hopefully he will grow bigger being in here in this pond. He was in a 55 gallon, but you know, I said it's not fair for him to be in there. So, and then this little minnow. So the story about these minnows is I do have some minnows in my pond currently. I don't even know if I could get it. I do have some minnows in my pond currently, but these are just the minnows that my bass didn't eat, my largemouth bass, and while we were quarantining, cleaning out the tank so we could add the peacock before they came, that fish came in, they were just sitting in there, and I'm like, that's not fair for them. So then I quarantined them in the 20 gallon for a while, and then I was like, you know what, might as well keep them, they've lived this long and survived, might as well. So the first ones I'm going to add in there is the minnow. Let's see how that goes. Now the waters are very similar, so I'm not worried about it being too cold or something gonna happen. Here and there, adding a cup every couple of minutes. So the fish is like they're okay to go in. So I'm going to add in now my Comet Savage. My pretty comet. All right, live free, Savage. Enjoy your new place. So, like, what the hell is this? And he's actually really, really fast, though. I'm not worried about him at all, not being able to just be like, oh, my friends. Here he is. Can you check the place out? Alright, now is my beloved veranda. This thing is a wild animal, so as you can see, I'm not going to be able to hold him for long. He's so pretty. I don't want to hurt him or stress him out. So I'm just going to slowly add him back in there. You see your koi best friend? They were like best friends, literally, in the tank. So I know he's been missing them. They've been together for a very long time, for the past couple months. So, yep, now is my time to clean up all these little things of poop. I got to splash up, make waves, and everything will be okay. Hey, Savage. Savage has always been a loner. I don't know why. It's the longest fish I've had, so he's very stunted. Feel bad, but he is well taken care of now. And I will never let that happen to another fish. So I wish my Aranda would come over here. Sandra might come up in the tank and look. I wanted to show you guys too. This one's tail has grown back so nice at the bottom. It's healed, so that's good. Other than that, look at him go, Veranda. Really thinking about putting fancy tails in here too, but they're really little and I don't want something happening to them. But hey, Goldie, you like going in the cave? Can you take them? This is my show off goldfish.
You'll show off. Everybody looks like they're doing good in here. Oh, the ramp is already up there. Swimming around. My Porsche pumpkin is the color. Yeah. He'll be fine. I have no worries about him. If I see any aggression with the two bigger ones, I'll go ahead and I'll take care of that, and I'll just go ahead and put him back in the tank. He's fine in a 55-gallon, but he's the biggest fish in there, and I know he likes being with, like, big squad. So, alright guys, I just wanted to show you the fish release.